In the series of admixture for concrete and its type like chemical admixture, mineral admixture, now I would like to request Dr. K. Mohan sir to tell us about mineral admixture like silica fume, effect of silica fume on fresh concrete, effect of silica fume on hardened concrete, use of silica fume, ground granulated blast furnace slag and effect of GGBFS on fresh concrete, etc.
Silica fume, also called condensed silica fume or micro silica, is a finely divided residue produced during the manufacture of silicon or ferrosilicon alloys by electric arc furnaces at temperatures of over 2000 degrees centigrade. It is a very fine Pozzolanic material composed of ultra fine amorphous glassy spheres. It has at least 85% silica SiO. It is extremely fine with particle size less than 1 micron and with an average diameter of about 0.1 micron, about 100 times smaller than average cement particles. It has a specific surface of about 20,000 meter square per kg as against 230 to 300 meter square per kg in case of OPC. The efficiency of silica fume depends upon its mineralogy and particle size distribution. The extremely fine particle size, large surface area, and high content of highly reactive amorphous silica give silica fume the super Pozzolanic property. Silica fume, being extremely finely divided, fills the voids between cement particles and makes the concrete very dense. Silica fume has become one of the necessary ingredients for making high strength and high performance concrete. Silica fume is covered under IS 15388 2003. Now, available form. Silica fume is available in the following form. Number one, undensified forms with bulk density 200 to 300 kg per meter cube. Then densified form with bulk density of 500 to 600 kg per meter. Then micro pelletized forms with bulk density of 500 to 600 kg per meter. And then slurry form with density 1400 kg per meter. Slurry is produced by mixing undensified micro silica powder and water in equal proportion by weight. Slurry is the easiest and most practical way to introduce micro silica into the concrete mix. Now I'll talk about effects of silica fume on fresh concrete. Water demand increases in proportion to the amount of silica fume. The increase in water demand of concrete containing silica fume will be 1% for every 1% of substituted. Therefore, 20 mm maximum size aggregate concrete containing 10% silica fume will have an increased content of about 20 liter per meter cube, increase water content of about 20 liter per meter cube. Measures can be taken to avoid this increase by adjusting the aggregate grading and using superplastic. The addition of silica fume will lead to lower slump but more cohesive mix. Silica fume make fresh concrete sticky in nature and hard to handle. There is a large reduction in bleeding, and concrete with silica fume could be handled and transported without segregation. Concrete containing silica fume can have plastic shrinkage cracking, and therefore, sheet or mat curing should be considered. Silica fume produces more heat of hydration at the initial stage of hydration. However, the total generation of heat will be less than that of reference. Now, effects of silica fume on hardened concrete. It increases ultimate strength gain, lowers permeability of concrete, increases durability of concrete, resistance against frost damage, that is, freeze-thaw cycle, reduces alkali aggregate reaction, reduces steel corrosion, reduces sulfate attack. Modulus of elasticity of micro silica concrete is less than concrete with micro silica at the same level of compressivist, users of silica to conserve cement, to produce ultra high strength concrete of order of 70 to 120 MPa, to increase early strength of fly ash or slag concrete, to control alkali aggregate reaction, to reduce sulfate attack and chloride associated corrosion. Now, India scenario. The following are some of the major products where silica fume is used in large quantity. Kaiga and Rajasthan nuclear power project, Tarapur atomic power project, JJ hospital flyover, Bandra Worli ceiling bridge at Mumbai, Nathpa Jakri hydroelectric power project. Now I'll discuss ground granulated blast furnace slag. Granulated blast furnace slag is a waste industrial byproduct obtained during the production of iron. Ground granulated blast furnace slag is a non-metallic product consisting essentially of silicates and aluminates of calcium and other bases. The molten slag is rapidly chilled by quenching in water to form a glassy sand-like granulated material. The granulated material, when further ground to less than 45 micron, will have a specific surface of about 400 to 600 meters square. The performance of slag largely depends on the chemical composition, glass content, and fineness of it. The quality of silica is governed by IS 12089-1987. Now I'll talk about effects of ground granulated blast furnace slag on fresh concrete. It reduces the unit water content necessary to obtain the same slump. The reduction of unit water content will be more pronounced with increase in slag content and also on the fineness of slag. Water used for mixing is not immediately lost, as the surface hydration of slag is slightly slower than that of cement. Then reduction of. Now, effects of ground granulated blast furnace slag on hardened. Reduced heat of hydration, refinement of pore structures, reduced permeabilities to the external agencies, increased resistance to chemical attack, improved resistance to corrosion of steel reinforcement, higher ultimate strength, improved workability of site mix, saving cement in